If you want to grow a successful cleaning business and then automate it, you need to watch this video. But first, a quick intro. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, my name is Mike Mack from the janitorialentrepreneur.com, and I help everyday people start, grow, and automate wildly profitable office cleaning businesses. And on this video, this is a very important video, I'm going to tell you why a cleaning business owner, you, the owner of a cleaning business, is too valuable to be cleaning. And before you get in your feelings, I'm gonna explain exactly why. But before we get into that, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and then turn on that notification bell, because I put out new videos just like this every single week and you're not gonna wanna miss them. Let me be specific. If you wanna start, grow, and automate your cleaning business, then subscribe to this channel because I got you covered. All right. Also, I put out videos once per week, but I'm also in my Facebook group. So if you want to hang out there, I do a live Q&A every single week. It's a free Facebook group. And the link to join is in the first comment, the pinned comment by me, by the channel page below. It's also in the description. So go look for it. It's a free Facebook group. Come join us, get questions answered, hang out, all that good stuff. All right. All that's over. Let's get into this week's video. Okay. Why am I making this video? I'm making this video because I posted a poll the other day. You could see it right here. And the poll is, do you think a cleaning business owner is too valuable to do their own cleaning? Now, I thought this was going to be a layup, honestly. I thought this would be the exact opposite, but no, I was mistaken. More than 70% of people think that is crazy that you should be doing the cleaning or you're not too valuable to do the cleaning in your own cleaning business. Well, this video, I'm going to give you three reasons. Yeah, three reasons why that is incorrect. And judging by the poll, I can tell this is a hot button issue for you, so I'm gonna not just talk about it, I'm gonna prove it. Let's get into it. Reason number one, the cleaning business owner is too valuable to be cleaning in his own company or her own company, of course, is many hats. So let me just tell it to you like this. Any business, I don't care what type of business, I don't care if it's an online business, an offline business, a brick and mortar business, no matter what, there are multiple aspects of running any business, right? And there's obviously no difference with cleaning companies. In the beginning, it is your job to wear multiple hats. You are literally the boss, the CEO. You're also head of sales. You're also head of marketing. You're also head of HR. You're also head of PR, public relations. You're in charge of all of that. Now, why I believe that you're too valuable to be doing the cleaning is because to have somebody run a company, if you had to give that position away to somebody, you're talking big bucks, depending on, like, you know, the size of your company and what you're looking for. What about someone to in management, someone to do your marketing? These are expensive positions. Like, it is expensive to outsource that. Do you know what I mean? But even that, I'll say, it's not just the cleaning. Eventually, the business owner has to be thinking, like, I'm too valuable to be doing this marketing by myself. I'm too valuable to be doing this, okay? Now, if your hangup is strictly the whole, oh, I'm not above cleaning. No one's above cleaning. It's not the point. The point is it's a business. Businesses are not about feelings. It's just looking at it from an actual boss standpoint. And you say to yourself, is this company better off with me doing the cleaning or outsourcing the cleaning? After all, depending on what state you live in or depending on where you live in, cleaning is like probably under 15 bucks an hour. You think you're gonna hire a marketer for 15 bucks an hour?
This is crazy, you're out of your mind.
Ha, good luck. Head of sales, ha. You're out of your mind. Do you see what I'm saying? That's why I say that, okay? So that's reason one, let's get into two. Reason number two, why you, the business owner of a cleaning company, is too valuable to be doing the cleaning. That is stunted growth. Yes, so when you're doing the cleaning all by yourself, you're doing all these accounts, or even you're splitting the cleaning, you know what you're not doing as well as you could be doing? Growing your company. That's right. Because you're doing the cleaning, that is taking you away from things like building strategic partnerships to get you more and more clients, being a better marketer, you know, doing better with your public relations, making better systems. How about this? Making your cleaning positions actually desirable. Because it's not just about hiring anybody anybody you find and just put them at an account. No, you want to create an actual environment that people like to come to work for, even love, okay? And you're not doing all that if you're spending your time cleaning. Do you see what I'm saying? Now listen, if you've gotten halfway through this video and if some reason you're mad, then tell you what, you're probably meant to be a professional cleaner. There's nothing wrong with that. That's what I did forever before I actually owned a company, all right? So if that's how you feel, do that, totally. But I'm telling you, I'm talking to the people who want to be entrepreneurs, the people who want to automate. And you know deep down in your heart that if you're doing other things besides growing your cleaning business and then automating, you are doing the people that agreed to work for you a disservice. Because the bigger a company grows, the more successful that company is, you have more power to make it a great position for people who need these positions. Do you see what I'm saying? You're taking food from people's mouth if you're clogging up this position, and you're not making it the best possible position if you're doing it yourself. Do you see what I'm saying? If you're not growing, you're not helping. You see what I'm saying? That's reason number two. Let's get into three. Reason number three, the cleaning business owner is too valuable to be doing the cleaning themselves, is it is an automation blocker. That's right. What is the purpose of an automated cleaning business? Well, can't tell you what your purpose is, but I can tell you what my purpose was for being obsessed with figuring out how to take a commercial cleaning company and automate it. Like, how do you get it to where you're only working like 5, 6, 7 hours a week? How do you do that? So that was an obsession of mine for a long time. And we finally figured it out and we've been fine tuning it, because you're always fine tuning and making it better, making it better, making it better. Let me tell you something, that takes time, that takes effort, especially if you've never done it before and you don't know what you're doing. That's a nightmare. Like, that takes a long time and there's a ton of trial and error, okay? So if you're doing all the cleaning, how are you gonna automate? So like I said, back to the original point of, you know, purpose. The purpose for automation, the purpose going through of all of that stuff is to spend more time with the people that matter most to you, doing the things that you love to do. This is why we do these things, right? Again, I can't tell you why you do it, I'm telling you why I do it. Spending more time with my wife, spending more time with my dogs, spending more time doing the things that I love with the people I love. That's why I do it. Now, I've been stuck doing the cleaning. That sucks, telling you from experience. Anyone who says like, oh no, I don't mind, come back to me and tell me what it's like when you're stuck in your cleaning business, when you're working 10 to 15 hours every single day, which I know sounds unbelievable, believe me, but we had no choice because we were stuck. And when you're stuck, it is so hard, because most people do it, they're like, oh, let's start hiring. Sorry, Jack, that's the wrong time to do it, because it's incredibly difficult. If you're stretched out to the absolute max, because you're just like, oh no, I'm not too valuable doing this. And since you think that like, oh no, it's totally cool, like I'm not valuable to be doing that, this is what you're doing. Now you're stuck like most cleaning companies out there. There's a billion cleaning companies out there. And you know, like, I wish I had a graphic to show you how stuck most of them are because of that thinking. And this is why I'm going hard in the paint on this, because I don't want you to be one of them, okay? I have a vested interest in you not being in it because it sucks. I know from experience. It sucks when you're the cleaning business owner, you're stuck doing the cleaning, and then something happens where you get sick, you get anything, or you get that virus that shall not be named, and then what happens? You're gonna tell all your accounts, sorry, can't do nothing about it. Or be a boss, put a great rock star employee there, and when that person gets sick with anything, you know, you replace them for the time being, and then when that person's not sick anymore, they come back to the account. Oh, and by the way, when you have a company that you've actually built and it is successful, like I said in the last one, doing your part to make it a better company, you have the ability to pay that worker who is out sick. Not many part-time jobs will do that. So if you're not doing that, you're not automating. And if you're not automating at least part of your company, then you don't really have a company. You kind of just have a job. And now that I think about it, I got one more reason. Okay, this is a bonus reason. This is one you really need to listen to. This is a bonus reason for why you are too valuable to be doing the cleaning if you are a business owner. Now, if you're a pro cleaner, this isn't for you. Obviously, do your thing. I'm talking to people who have a desire to build a company that fills them with joy, fills them with pride, creates positions that people enjoy working with. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. So the last bonus reason why you shouldn't be doing the cleaning yourself is small vibes company. Yeah, what's a small vibes company? Let me tell you something right now. When you start going after more premium accounts, it is a very big deterrent if you're doing the cleaning yourself. You know why? Because they know. They've fallen for that before. They've fallen for that before by the people who come in and underbid them. A lot of times people just underbid because they're not worried about payroll. They're not worried about all the things that go into it. They're gonna come in with the lowest bid. The bigger companies that fall for that, they realize it's just maybe you and your spouse and then maybe a couple of like kids, and then you guys are running around, you know, as a family doing it. But then guess what? When people get sick, it's the same thing. Then they're stuck because they didn't hire a company that can fit their needs. Now, this will work for smaller accounts, don't get me wrong, but I'm saying the bigger accounts, if you want the cream of the crop accounts, they're not gonna be into the fact that you do the cleaning yourself. Even though you can undercut all the other companies and you can like way underbid, no one's gonna be enthused by the fact that it's you and maybe your two best friends, and then, you know, they gotta think, oh, what if these guys argue and then they don't agree on payment structure after a few months, and then they just, now we're back in the same boat looking for another cleaning company. I'm telling you right now, I'm telling you from the absolute experience, when myself and Jess were stuck doing the cleaning, and I remember our first big dealership came around and we were so excited about it. I still remember that dealership. It took us 2 years to actually get it again. We had them on the cusp. It's a big BMW dealership, and we had them, we were in the clothes, and they were like, right on the spot, do you have a team? Or it's like, can we meet the team that you're going to have actually servicing our space? And Jess and I were like, you're looking at them. And they were like, yeah. And that was it. The deal blew up. And like I said, it took 2 years to actually come back and let them know that we're actually legit company now, or not just like kind of like a mom and pop kind of situation. Do you see what I'm saying? That's a big deterrent, and it's another reason why you shouldn't be doing the cleaning yourself. Okay, in conclusion, at the end of the day, you do whatever it is that you want, okay? I honestly am only trying to help you through this process. And this is what I would tell you if you were in my private coaching group. I'm telling you the exact same thing I tell people that invest in themselves and join my program, okay? Let me just tell you this. If you take nothing else from me, please take this at least. Drop that mindset that you're not too valuable to be doing the cleaning. Because let me tell you this, as a human being, no, you're not, you're right. I'm not too valuable to be doing cleaning, because as humans, we're not. No one's better than anyone. We're talking about in the business space. We're talking about how much value you bring to each position, right? If you are valuable at selling, then you need to be selling and then automate the rest. If you're valuable at marketing, then you need to be marketing and automate the rest. Do you see what I'm saying? If the most value you bring to a cleaning company is you're a good cleaner, that's not bad. You could still do it. I would just say that you kind of have a tougher hill ahead because you don't know how to go out there and get clients. You don't know how to negotiate. You don't know how to scout, don't know how to put out a PR. You don't know how to do any of that. So again, you still can do it. It's just you're kind of starting from a bit of a disadvantage. So if that's your position, I totally get it. What I would recommend is go clean. Don't start your business yet. I would go clean for a competitor. And then I would just kind of like figure out what they do and then start figuring out like, okay, how would I make my company different? Or how could I use something and not use this and kind of make my own company? It's just honest advice, all right? That's it for this video. Seriously, I hope I got through with this. Usually I'm like, I hope you got massive value, and I truly, truly, truly mean that, but I really hope that this you really took to heart, and I hope I was able to challenge you a little bit. If you disagreed with this and if you're like totally on board and you just dig in the content, hit the thumbs up, because I appreciate you all for watching. In all seriousness, like I said before, if you're new in town, you know, you're just checking everything out and you're curious about what it's like to start a cleaning business, or myself and my wife's story of how we started with, you know, not much, this is a free masterclass. Also, if you want to learn more, if you want to hang out during the week in between videos, join my free Facebook group. You can go over it right now by, you know, clicking the link in the description. Also, you can click the link in the pinned comments. That's right. Sorry. Trying to remember it. All right. But seriously, you guys are the best. I'll see you on the next video. Don't do the cleaning yourself unless you absolutely have to in the beginning for a second, but then get out. You get it. Peace out.
Whoa. Hey, thanks for watching the video. What are you still doing here? You want to check out more stuff? You want to grow your cleaning business? You want to grow it to the next level? You want to automate and scale all that fun stuff? Check out this video. Or check out this video. And have you subscribed? I mean, seriously, it's right there. Just click. You're subscribed. All you got to do is click right there. Or you should check this video out. Or check this video out. I don't know. Do your thing. I'll see you on the next one.